I'm Dr. Gitanjali Adlakha-Hutcheon. I'm a defense scientist at Defense Research and Development Canada. My invention is MAD. MAD stands for Methodology for Assessing Disruptions. It's a war game. It comes in two parts. Part one is oriented towards the scientists and engineers, and part two involves players that are military officers.
One of the great things about this methodology is that it's really scalable. We can use large joint problems, or we can focus it on a narrower area. And as we develop the idea further, we can use that as a basis for doing more conventional type of simulation or other research that's beneficial to the military.
So during MAD, what happens is that it's a traditional seminar war game in part two, where the military officers play. And they play using the fictitious idea cards developed by the scientists. When they play those, they realize which cards allow them to get an edge over the enemy. And then they realize through the move of the opposite team that there is a counter move possible. So the insight that the military gets is where would they not be able to defeat a counter move? So there's a move, there's a counter move, and where do they get stuck? For the military, this is important in terms of planning their moves. For the scientists, it's important in understanding what stumps us. So how can we better provide an aid to the military which will not stump the military? So the MAD game really came from serendipity, but also from the notion of how do we talk to the military and talk early on rather than after the fact? And so one of the ways was, what gives the military an edge? What makes their situational awareness even better? Well, the answer is very clear. It's a disruptive technology. And so a disruptive technology, by the connotation of the name itself, is a technology that would change the field of operations. A disruptive technology could provide us with the advantage to win over the adversary, but also indicate to us, well, gee whiz, this might be a vulnerability we have and that we need to work on building countermeasures to against another disruptive technology. So what makes MAD a different war game is that it allows the initiation of a very early conversation between the world of the scientists and the world of the military.
One of the great things about MAD 3 is that if you want to focus on a particular area and really explore it in more detail, you can use this methodology that complements other things that we do. And it might be more fully developed simulation or more traditional simulation wargaming, but this really allows us to look at those areas that we want to investigate further to identify them for, you know, maybe further funding down the road or additional scientific research.
It's touching upon the unseen and the future, and it's giving us the capability to plan way ahead, very science fiction, very much down the line of what gets scientists going. Yoga, in its very essence, means integration. So you integrate two opposites. Yoga allows one to be very aware. MAD is devoid of too much technology, but yet it's talking about technology. Yoga doesn't have all the fitness machines, and yet it gives you all the strengths and all the subtle adaptability and flexibility of body that you can get with all those machines. And in a war game, what I'm seeking to achieve is provide the military much more situational awareness. In an ideal world is that we'd want people to have to be able to check mark their resume and say, I've participated in MAD. This little MAD, not only is it low cost, but it allows joint participation by invitation. So if you haven't heard of MAD, go out there, look for MAD, and ask your general to help you participate.